The transition property defines how a UI element behaves in each state, and how it behaves when changing states. The following lesson uses the button element as an example, but transitions work the same for each UI element with transitions. By default, the button element will display the normal state of the button. Depending upon the transition mode chosen, a button can also display a highlighted, pressed, and disabled state. Transition mode determines whether or not the button element will display any of these additional states, and if so, controls the button's look in each state, and the style of the transition between these states. The highlighted state is set when the pointer is hovering over the button element, or the button element is selected using keyboard or controller navigation. The pressed state is when the button is being held down, pressed but not released. The disabled state is set when the button element is not interactable. The look and behavior of these other transition states, if available, are determined by the transition mode. The transition mode can be set with a transition pop-up menu. None will have no additional states and therefore no transitions. The button element will work as expected, but there will be no visual feedback, and the unaltered normal state will be displayed at all times. Color tint is the default transition mode. In this mode, the same graphical element is used for each state. Target graphic is the image component to be tinted. Normal, highlighted, pressed, and disabled color define the tint color that will be applied to the target graphic when the button is in each of these states. Color multiplier multiplies the tint color for each transition by its value. This allows for colors greater than 1, which is useful for brightening the colors or alpha channel on some graphic elements whose base color is less than white or less than full alpha. Fade duration is the time, in seconds, the transition takes between states. Sprite swap will use different sprite images for each state, and swaps them depending upon the state of the button. In this mode, a new graphical element is required for each state. Target graphic is the image for the normal state. The highlighted, pressed, and disabled sprites are references to the sprite images to be displayed for each state. Animation allows for each transition to be fully animated using Unity's animation system. This is the most powerful of transition modes due to the number of properties that can be animated simultaneously. To use the animation transition mode, an animator component needs to be attached to the button element. To add this animator component automatically and generate an animator controller with states already set up, click Auto Generate Animation. The new animator controller will need to be saved. No action needs to be taken with this new animator controller. The transition between states can be customized if desired, but this is not necessary. For more information on the animator component and the animator controller, please see the information link below. It is worth noting that, unlike most animator controllers, this controller will also store the animations for the button's transitions. With the animator controller attached, and the button element selected, the animations for each of these button states can be edited by opening the animation window. The animation window can be found under Window, Animation, or by using the shortcut keys of Command 6 on the Mac or Control 6 on Windows. To select the state to be edited, use the Animation Clip pop-up menu to select the desired clip. With these pre-made controllers, there should be a state for normal, highlighted, pressed, and disabled. In most cases, the normal state will be left empty, with no animation keyframes created, as the normal state will be set by the values on the button element itself. On all other states, the most common configuration for each state is a single keyframe at 0 seconds, or the start of the timeline. The transition animation between states will be handled by the animator controller as it fades between states. For example, the width of the button in the highlighted state could be changed. By selecting the state to be edited, in this case highlighted from the animation clip pop-up menu, and with the playhead at 0 seconds, or the start of the timeline. Selecting the Record button, changing the width of the button in the inspector, and exiting record mode. When in play mode, note how the button now grows when highlighted. It is worth noting that any number of properties can have their value set in this one keyframe. For more information on animation, animation clips, and the animation window, please see the information link below. If several buttons share the same behavior, these button elements can share animator controllers. Make sure all of these buttons have their transition mode set to animation, and that they all have an animator component attached. Finally, associate the shared animator controller with all of the button elements. When in play mode, note how all of the buttons now share the same animated transitions,